नरेश गुजराल जी, माय कॉलीग इन द राज्यसभा, द अदर फैमिली मेंबर्स ऑफ श्री इंद्र कुमार गुजराल जी, श्री राजू चंद्रशेखर, श्री सीएम रमेश, श्री वाईएस चौधरी, श्री एमएस बुंदर, श्री जयराम रमेश, मिस्टर प्रताप बाजवा, सुखबीर बादल जी, हरसिमरत बादल जी आर ऑल्सो सपोज टू जॉइन अस आई थिंक, मनीष तिवारी मेंबर पार्लियामेंट, डॉक्टर जसपाल सिंह एंड माय ओल्ड फ्रेंड श्री त्रिलोचन सिंह जी, श्री शैलव कुमार चीफ पोस्ट मास्टर जनरल तमिलनाडु सर्किल, श्रीमती सुमति रविचंद्रन पोस्ट मास्टर जनरल चेन्नई, एंड द अदर डिस्टिंग्विश्ड गेस्ट एंड अदर्स वॉचिंग दिस प्रोग्राम ऑनलाइन। आई वॉज कीन एंड ऑल्सो नरेश जी ऑल्सो वॉज कीन दैट वी शुड हैव ए फिजिकल फंक्शन इन दिल्ली। आई इनिशियली अग्रीड but later seeing the weather condition in Delhi and also the vulnerability and all, I have to leave Delhi and come to this side. Today I am in Chennai Raj Bhavan. I am pleased to release the commemorative stamp in honor of the former Prime Minister, Sri Inder Kumar Gujral ji, on his birth anniversary today. I would like to compliment the Postal Department, the Minister and other officers who are all concerned for readily accepting and bringing out a nice postal stamp, the memory of the former Prime Minister of this country. Sri Gujral ji was born in Jhelum in 1919, as it was explained in the noted freedom fighter's family. And then later, he migrated to India. I'm happy that Sri Naresh Gujral ji has explained about the background, the early days of Sri Inder Kumar Gujral ji. This is very much necessary because the present generation, the youngsters, they need to know much about the leaders who had made great contribution to this great country. That's why this brief history of Sri Naresh Gujral ji is very important. I'm happy. Inder Kumar Gujral ji's life has been explained by Naresh Gujral ji. As was explained, he started his political career as a student leader. And he was also president of the Punjab University Students Union. He also participated in the freedom movement and was arrested during the Quit India movement along with his entire family, as was explained. Really, it's a good news that his background and entire family taking part in freedom struggle. And after partition, and he came this side and settled down in Delhi, he was elected unopposed to the Electoral College of Delhi. Later, he was also appointed, nominated as Vice President of the New Delhi Municipal Committee in DMC. In 1964, he was elected to Rajya Sabha from Delhi and later joined the government led by Srimati Indira ji as the Minister of State for Parliament Affairs and Communications. He held various important portfolios in the Union government, including works and housing, communications, parliamentary affairs, information broadcasting, Some of these portfolios I remember, I also worked as a minister for works and housing, parliamentary affairs, information broadcasting, in addition to the other portfolios. So he made an immense contribution during his tenure as minister to the development of the country. He also served as external affairs minister in the cabinets of Sri V.P. Singh and Sri Deyagowda. He also served as a leader of the Rajya Sabha, 96-98. And 97, he assumed as the Prime Minister of India. Sri Gujralji was a learned man, soft spoken, and a gentle politician who never compromised on his values irrespective of the changes or hardships he had faced. Bearing an amiable demeanor, he was courteous to a fault and made friends across the political spectrum. That is the need of our all politicians, must maintain good relations with others. We are all in public life, including in politics, they should consider each other as rivals, not as enemies. And they should have social connections. The present generation need to take inspiration from such personalities and conduct. He was indeed a multifaceted personality and authored several books, enjoyed reading and reciting poetry. He used to take a keen interest in theater and visual arts. He will always be remembered for the Gujral doctrine enunciated by him during his tenure as India's External Affairs Minister. My dear sisters and brothers, every nation formulates its foreign policy in line with its national interest. Nation first. That policy should be followed by each and everyone. Political parties, leaving aside their political difference and shades, all should join as far as foreign policy is concerned, because we are dealing with other nations and everyone must work in the interest of the nation. No policy can remain static or be cast in stone in a dynamically evolving geopolitical situation. India always believed in peaceful coexistence with all its neighbors and maintaining friendly relations. We always believed in our ancient philosophy of Vasudhaika Kutumbakam, Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu. We are concerned and we are committed to the welfare of the entire humanity. Unfortunately, India, we have been facing relentless state-sponsored cross-border terrorism for the past several years. Today, the whole world is facing one of the worst economic and health crises in the wake of the COVID pandemic. And this is the time for all nations, particularly those in South Asia, to focus on rebuilding economies, ramping health infrastructure and protecting livelihoods. South Asia is home to almost a quarter of the world population. The potential and scope for cooperation and development of the region is huge, and all countries in the region must seize the opportunity to build a better and brighter future for the people by eliminating barriers like poverty, illiteracy, corruption, providing quality education and healthcare, ending gender discrimination, and according priority to enhancing the overall quality of life. That is the ultimate aim. Peace and development should take precedence over everything else. Peace is the prerequisite for progress, and no development can take place without peace. Indra Kumar Gujral ji has successfully pursued the cause of the nation. Then he was Minister for External Affairs. And also, then he worked as ambassador to USSR at that time. The SAARC regional grouping can become an effective and vibrant network to promote prosperity and well-being of the vast multitudes in the region only if all the countries come together sincerely in stamping out the scourge of terrorism. Unless totally wiped out, the menace of terrorism will negate all the efforts to create a prosperous and flourishing future for all in South Asia. This has to be kept in mind by all the people, the region, and also for that matter, the entire world community. I feel the time has come for the United Nations to play a more proactive role and step up its efforts in isolating nations sponsoring terrorist activities and in imposing sanctions against them to deter them from encouraging terror. The conclusion of deliberations at the United Nations and the adoption of the Comprehensive Convention on International Terrorism cannot brook any further delay. It is already delayed. My dear sisters and brothers and my dear friends, on this occasion of the virtual release of postal stamp on one of our great leaders, the former Prime Minister, Sri Indra Kumar Gujral ji, I would like to say something on the need for greater participation of women in leadership roles and women empowerment. I am here, as I told you, in Tamil Nadu. On this occasion, I would like to refer to a landmark achievement of Tamil Nadu yesterday. I am extremely delighted to know that the Madras High Court has now the highest number of 13 women judges, with the elevation of 4 more women to the bench yesterday. Of the 63 judges, 13 are now women, accounting for about 21% of the total, the highest in the country. This is highly commendable and worthy of emulation by others. I compliment the Madras High Court, the Supreme Court of India, the Government of Tamil Nadu, and the Government of India for this commendable initiative. Since the appointment of Justice Pathima B.V. as the first woman judge in the Supreme Court, she was also governor of Tamil Nadu, only 8 women served as judges of the apex court so far. They include 2 women judges currently on the bench out of the total 33 judges. In the 25 high courts of the country, we have only 78 women judges. This is gross underrepresentation of women in the higher judiciary. This takes us to the debate over the ability of women to don the leadership roles which involve complex decision making. The leadership is not about physical attributes. It is more about cognitive abilities and other attributes that enable a holistic examination of issues under examination. The number of women in leadership roles in politics, public administration, corporate governance, and civil society organizations has been steadily increasing over the years, both in India and the world. We also have a woman as the Postmaster General of Chennai. It all shows that given an opportunity, they will excel in their responsibilities. Of course, as I was mentioning about the increasing roles, but the ratio of their representation does not match with the number of women in the society. Reservations have been provided for women in the local bodies. They're doing a good job. With the experience they are asserting themselves without the need for being assisted by their husbands. Sometimes proving to be better than their husbands. Low representation of women in the legislature and states and in parliament is still a matter of concern. This needs to be enhanced significantly through necessary political and legislative initiatives. I am not talking of reservation. I am talking of the proper representation of women, be in the legislature, parliament, or even the judiciary. The 17th Lok Sabha has the highest number of 78 women members, accounting still only to 14% of the total. It needs to be enhanced further. It cannot be the immense world any longer. Prejudice against women shall be brought to an end at the earliest. Women deserves their share of opportunities to express themselves in all forms in the emerging knowledge society. Gender-based discrimination has no role, has no justification. On the contrary, giving women their due will make our homes and the world better places to live. Women deserves high seats in all spheres of decision making, as I said, including judiciary, legislature, and governance of all kinds. We need to focus on removing the entry barriers to women. It is for this reason, I compliment all the concerned for enabling presence of 30 women judges in the Madras High Court. This should inspire others. Why I am saying this today? We are recalling the services offered by a great son of this great country. On such occasions, we must ponder about the development we have made. We have definitely made development, undoubtedly. Under the recent past, development is moving faster, but it moves much more faster. The reason being, we are now being recognized and respected worldwide. The focus is more on India. We must take care of the shortcomings, if any, and also the gaps here and there, the fault lines, if any, and see to it that we move on to become a developed nation. India was known as Vishwaguru once upon a time, Nalanda, then Takshashila, Vikramshila, Pushpagiri, they were all seats of learning. And even in every sphere, Aryabhatta, Bhaskara, so many people, Susruta, Charaka, many examples are there. India always had that excellence, knowledge. There is no dearth of knowledge. What is required, you have to identify, you have to encourage people. So that's why I thought when we are celebrating the 101st Jayanti of our former Prime Minister, I should share some thoughts with you on various aspects of public life. The COVID pandemic has severely impacted the economy and disrupted our lives in an unprecedented manner. And we are recovering slowly. That's the news. Good news. For that, all people should work together. Center, states, other stakeholders must all work as a team India. Here, I must express my deep appreciation for all the frontline corona warriors, doctors, nurses, healthcare workers, police, sanitation staff, media personnel, for their selfless service during the pandemic. And also would like to compliment the central government and the state governments for the initiatives they are taking to combat this pandemic. But at the end of the day, it is the people who have to really work together, follow the directions issued from time to time by the central government, by the state government, by other agencies, and see to it that we are able to face this in a more effective manner and get happy days earlier. I would also like to specially compliment our farmers who worked tirelessly in spite of hardship and restriction during the lockdown to produce sufficient food grains, why sufficient more also. The happy news that the sowing and production and compared with the previous year has gone up. That is, hats off to the farming community, and we must address their problems, genuine problems, try to see that further, lot of improvements are being made. Government have taken many initiatives, undoubtedly, new initiatives, but many more initiatives to be taken, and see to it that the farmers get remunerative price. That is the basic thing. And provide with all the infrastructure support. My dear sisters and brothers, before concluding, I would like to appeal to the people to not to lower the guard and continue to take all precautions by following COVID-19 protocols like wearing a mask, frequent hand washing, and maintaining a safe distance, Surakshita Duri. I don't call it a social distance, but safe distance, Surakshita Duri. That will really help us. Let us lead a healthy and safe lifestyle as we wait for the arrival of the vaccine. I assure you, as I told you earlier, we have a great future. Happy days are ahead, but we should all perform our responsibilities. Recalling the memories of Sri Indra Kumar Gujralji and some of the achievements he has made is to inspire the younger generation. Let us all take inspiration from his life and see to it that they are followed. I have great pleasure in releasing the first day cover of the stamp in memory of Sri Indra Kumar Gujralji. And I would like to compliment the family members, particularly Sri Naresh Gujral and also the Postal Department, Government of India, for making all the arrangements for this function. Thank you very much. Namaskar. Jai Hind.